Now, as promised, the Proms debut of one of this country's leading actors, Jeremy Irons. Since his unforgettable portrayal of Charles Ryder in the hit television series Brideshead Revisited, Jeremy Irons has become a sought-after leading man on the big screen, starting out with The French Lieutenant's Woman in 1981, and going on to star in Dead Ringers, Damage, Lolita, and Reversal of Fortune, for which he won the Best Oscar for Best Actor. And now here are Jeremy Irons and Sir Andrew Davis to perform this tribute to Noel Coward.
Tropical climes at a certain times of day, when all the citizens retire to tear their clothes off and perspire, it's one of those rules that the greatest fools obey, because the sun is much too sultry and one must avoid its ultraviolet rays. That's natives. The natives grieve when the white men leave their huts, because they're obviously definitely nuts. Dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday sun. The Japanese don't care to, the Chinese wouldn't dare to. Hindus and Argentines sleep firmly from 12 to 1. But Englishmen detesta siesta. In the Philippines there are lovely screens to protect you from the glare. In the Malay states they wear hats like plates, which the Britishers don't wear. In Bengal, lose it all, no, for the work is done. But mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday sun. It's such a surprise for the Eastern eyes to see that though the English are effete, they're quite impervious to heat. When the white man rides, every native hides in glee. For will the simple creatures hope he will impale his solar topi on a tree? It's more natives, pay no attention. It seems such a shame when the English claim the earth that they give rise to such hilarity and mirth. Ha, ha, ha. Mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday sun. The toughest Burmese bandit can never understand it. In Rangoon, the heat of noon is just what the natives shun. They put their scotch or rye down and lie down. In the jungle town where the sun beats down to the rage of man and beast, the English garb of the English Tsar merely gets a bit more creased. In Bangkok at 12 o'clock, they foam at the mouth, run! But mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday sun. Mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday sun. The smallest Malay rabbit deplores this foolish habit. In Hong Kong, they strike a gong and fire off a noonday gun. To reprimand each inmate who's in late. In the mangrove swamps where the python romps, there's peace from 12 till 2. Even caribous lie around and snooze, there's nothing else to do. In Bengal, to move at all is seldom, if ever, done. But now dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday, 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 sound pipe! And now I... Now, having been so rudely interrupted, I should like to sing you a song about a very disagreeable young lady from South America, who throughout her long and colorful life resolutely refused to dance. Her name was Nina. Senorita Nina from Argentina knew all the answers, although her relatives and friends were perfect dancers. She swore she'd never dance a step until she died. she said, I've seen too many movies, and all they prove is too idiotic. They all insist that South America's exotic, whereas it couldn't be more boring if it tried. She added firmly that she hated the sun of softy dark beside her still lagoon. And then she positively stated that she could not abide a southern moon. She said with most refreshing candor that she thought Carmen Miranda was subversive propaganda and should rapidly be shot. She said she didn't care a jot if people quoted her or not. She refused to make anybody when they requested it. And she made an embarrassing scene if anyone suggested it, for she detested it. No one ever could be keener than little Nina on quite a number of very eligible men who did the rumba. When they proposed to her, she simply left them flat. She said that love should be impulsive, but not convulsive. And syncopation had a discouraging effect on procreation. And that she'd rather read a book, and that was that. Senorita Nina from Argentina despised the tango. Although she never was a girl to let a man go, she wouldn't sacrifice her principles for sex. She looked with scorn on the gyrations of her relations who danced the conga, and swore that if she had to stand it any longer, she'd lose all dignity and wring their silly necks. Family, she was blind and all their advertised romantic charms. And then she got more bloody minded and told them where to put their tropic palms. She said, I hate to be pedantic, but I'm driven nearly frantic when I see that unromantic, sycophantic lot of sluts forever wriggling their guts. It drives me absolutely nuts. She declined within the they besought her to, and she language profane and obscene. She cursed the man who taught her to. She cursed Cole Porter too. From this it's very clear that Nina, in her demeanor, was so offensive that when the hatred of her friends grew too intensive, she thought she'd better beat it while she had the chance. After some trials and tribulations, she reached the station and met a sailor who had acquired a wooden leg in Venezuela. And so she married him because he couldn't dance. And she never could have been a more irritating girl than Nina. They never speak in Argentina of this degenerate bambina who had the luck to find romance, and as others they wouldn't die. Is it that civilized humanity has made this world so wrong? In this hurly-burly of insanity, our dreams cannot last long. We've reached the deadline, the press headline
every song.